A lot of people looked at the LED panel, so asking questions. So I will make a very short presentation about it. So it will not be only about channels, but I will talk about channels because it's related to it. So last year we did a previous channel recipes conference, and then because it did work well, we chose to do the same thing about distribution. So we were crazy enough to organize it. And then after the kernel recipe, we noticed that for people, it's not quite easy to know what time is remaining for the current presentation. So we tried to find a way to show them how many time it was remaining. So we looked on our desk and noticed that we had two LED panels, and we need also something to control them. So we looked at the various arm boards we had at hand, and we wanted to be able to control it. So we needed to be able to convert the Wi-Fi device into an access point. So we found several boxes, and the only one which was really a box and not only a PCB with USB port was the smart top from Genesis. And hopefully it was supported by mainline kernel. Well, not the GPU part, but we don't need any kind of GPU, so no problem. We choose to install it on a Debian, so, well, nice, works. And we needed to create something to control the LED panel. And so what we choose to do was to connect remotely by SSH on the device, and then control through USB the two panels. Behind the panels, you can see that after, you have two controllers to control the different LEDs. And they're talking through serial port, and you have small adapters on the boards to get USB support. So what did I do was to write a small plugin of GStreamer to lead the two panels, and it's a very simple device. So I needed some example to learn how to create plugins. So I used the KakaSync driver, which is the ASCII art driver. So you can have your terminal text terminal to show your movie, and it's called the library used is called Kaka. So they made the KakaSync. Yeah, it's funny. So I needed something to create the video because GStreamer is using streams. So I use a video test source, which is giving various patterns and hopefully some streams to be used. And then I did some resizing because the panel is small, so I need something to resize it. And so I did it and it worked well. Was fine. So after these two recipes, we go back to work and stuff and let it on its place. So the kernel at this time was very well supported, but over the time I've updated the distribution running on the device, and then unfortunately I got some troubles because device 3 came, the FreeCell folks started to convert it to device 3. And also, they chose to change the USB driver. There was a specific USB driver, and they decided to use a common driver for the MSM, Qualcomm, and Shepard, and FreeCell, and so on. So, yeah, using a common driver is nice, but unfortunately, the problem was that the support is not still, even today, not as good as what you had with the specific drivers. And the problem is that everything on the device is connected through USB, so no USB. So I had to quickly fix the kernel. So this morning during my presentation, I talked about various things, like I talked about a commit, and this commit was found while trying to get it work back. And I found also some other troubles, but they are not directly related to the LED display, so I won't talk about it. But that shows that even if it's supported by a kernel you update it, you update your distro, you have to update your kernel, and well, currently the support is so bad that the board are not supported anymore by the kernel. You only have out of three patches, which is, well, quite annoying. So that's it. If you want more detail, we made some time ago a blog post about it when we just created the system. So if you want to have more details, you'll find them. You have also a snapshot, small screenshot of the GStreamer pipeline we made. So if you want all details, you have that. You have the code used for the GStreamer plugin. So you should be able to use it and look at it. That's it.